Hey guys, it's that time of the year again and love is in the air. Who doesn't enjoy watching The Notebook, Titanic or Love Story while curling up in their couches? But you know what we love even more? These tender love stories that are actually real. So get ready to laugh, cry and swoon over these most touching love stories that we have rounded up for you in anticipation of Cupid's favorite holiday. Be sure to have popcorn and tissues ready. More than 40 years ago, a beautiful love story began between an Indian man and a young Swedish woman. Pradyumna Kumar Mahanandiya was born in a remote village in eastern India. And despite coming from a very poor background, earned a place as a student at College of Art, Delhi. It is here that he shot to fame by drawing the portrait of Indira Gandhi. Many people wanted him to draw them, and one of them was a young girl student named Charlotte Vaughan Shedwin, who was traveling in India. That portrait changed their lives as they fell in love with each other and got married. Charlotte, however, had to return to Sweden and ask Pradyumna to come with her. But he did not have enough money to buy a plane ticket and decided he would go on his own later. After she left, the two kept in touch through letters. The love story would have ended there, but young and determined Kumar decided not to let that happen. After a year and a half spent apart, the artist sold everything he had and bought a bicycle with very little money. Kumar managed to travel for almost 5 months on his bicycle, covering 6,400 kilometers across 8 countries to get to Sweden. The two lovers ended up throwing a full Indian wedding and have been together for more than 40 years now. The couple has raised 2 children together and their love is as strong as ever. In 2018, a wedding video went viral and gathered over 300 million views. And it wasn't because of handsome group of groomsmen dancing. There's a good chance you're already familiar with Elizabeth Shoesmith. Her heartwarming performance of signing the words of a love song to Scott, her deaf husband-to-be, before walking down the aisle has been featured on many shows. But more than anything, Elizabeth's efforts to shape a more welcoming world for all people go well beyond their wedding day. Elizabeth has now launched the Inclusive Foundation that seeks to promote inclusion and diversity to make this world a better place for everyone. What better way to honor someone you love? Some love stories last even longer than life itself. For 6 years now, 94-year-old Ted Richardson has visited his late wife's grave at National Memorial Cemetery every morning at 6:30 a.m. sharp. When interviewed, Ted stated that when he goes up there, he always leaves her a bouquet of flowers as payback for 72 wonderful years of marriage. If you wonder what devotion looks like, here it is. Flowers are a great way to express your feelings for someone. Red roses say, "I love you," but a whole garden of pink flowers screams it. One husband took the romantic gesture of getting your wife flowers to next level. Mr. and Mrs. Kuroki, an elderly couple who once ran a dairy farm in Shintomi town in Miyazaki, had planned taking a trip around Japan after they retired. After 30 years of marriage, Mrs. Kuroki suddenly lost her eyesight due to some complications caused because of diabetes. To cheer his wife up, Mr. Kuroki spent 2 years planting a field of thousands of pink Shibasakura flowers in their garden. He hoped that his wife would enjoy the smell and that visitors attracted by the vibrant garden would keep his wife company. Now, 10 years later, the garden has turned into a tourist spot visited by thousands of people. we don't know about the Garden of Eden, but the Garden of Kuroki's surely looks like paradise on earth. When Amy Rosenthal knew she was dying of ovarian cancer, she wrote an essay in the New York Times Modern Love column called "You May Want to Marry My Husband." With only days left to live, she told the world everything she loved about her husband of 26 years. Amy wrote in the essay, "I'm wrapping this up on Valentine's Day, and the most genuine gift I can hope for is that the right person finds Jason and another love story begins." 10 days later, Amy died at the age of 51. Jason Rosenthal now teaches people about dealing with grief and also gave a fantastic TED talk about it. If this is not love, we don't know what is. We hope you liked this video. If you did, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to our channel for more incredible stories. Keep watching The Off Factory and keep spreading love.